IVM.
Yes, it's all available on Storytel. By all, I mean great books. Some have changed my life. One which comes to mind immediately is, and don't laugh, Right Body for You. That's right. A book I read from start to finish. It didn't change my body, but it changed my look at how I look at my body, which is I don't look at it anymore. But Right Body for You will help you gain the kind of figure or physique that you want. I know this is true because I've gone and seen people change in front of my eyes. That's because I used to work at a tailor shop, but that's another story. Right Body for You. So keep in mind that if you go through storytel.com/IVM, you get a 30-day free trial as against a 14-day free trial on the link. All right, it's very simple. All you got to do is log on to storytel.com/IVM. Millions and millions and millions of stories, many written by me. All that and more. Find it all on Storytel. The language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen, yaar, don't be so conservative.
You're listening to Cyrus Says.
So if you ever get caught by the enemy and are given a thorough poochtaj interrogation session, what's it going to be like? Find out right now, because I've been caught by my enemy. My clothes are off, the gloves are off, and let's see what happens. Q&A with Cyrus Broacha.
Why follow your auntie's advice when you can follow Cyrus Says on Facebook and Twitter to stay updated about the latest shows?
All right, so it's question time, which is a special edition of Cock and Bull, which used to be Cyrus Says. And we keep changing names because of numerology, nothing else. Otherwise, we would have stayed with Cyrus Says. But first, I have something to rant about. And that is, I finally found it. I'm sick of hearing this. Indians are all over England because of World Cup. Indians are everywhere. Cricket crazy. Diwani, Diwani, Diwani. Cricket, cricket, cricket. I found three Indians who are in England and don't watch the World Cup and never will. Number one, and above all, Dr. Vijay Mallya. Number two, and above all, Nirav Modi. Number three, and above both of them, Kunal Vijaykar. Yep. It's called Cock and Bull Special Question Time. We'll be back after this break.
Hi, I'm Anupam Gupta, B50 on Twitter. And listen in to the Equity Sahiya podcast brought to you by Motilal Oswal Asset Management Company. The Equity Sahiya podcast offers deep investment insights into the potential of many sectors in India which are growing and have a lot to offer for your portfolio. New episodes out every Tuesday on the IVM Podcast app or any other app where you get your podcasts from.
All right, show started. We're all so excited because
yes,
Abbas, my producer, hi Amit, he actually said that today is like an exam.
It is.
It's like a big AMA, huge AMA.
Well, it's
moment.
It's a sort of AMA. It's more like, so what we've been we're doing this thing where we're talking to all of our different hosts about, like, you know, different things so that people can get to know them a little bit better.
Yeah.
And
so almost like a matrimonial ad, you know, meet his complexion, you know, a virgin, never been touched before, never been touched again. Yeah.
So we're going to be doing a fairly large social media push around this, and you're going to start seeing a lot of stuff. But what we thought we'll do over here is we've asked all of them a variety of questions. We're going to ask you all of them. We're going to put this out as
Is
episode.
It possible to answer all the questions with yes or no?
No.
Not really.
But you just did.
Well, you can answer some of the questions with yes or no, but I don't think that you'll be able to answer
so
a lot.
So my first answer to the question that you may ask is no, even though I don't know what
it's,
it is.
Okay.
Seems like I hit gold. Abbas is laughing. Struck well. Good one. One down.
Well, kind of.
Okay.
No, not one down. You have to elaborate on the no.
Okay.
You want to know the question?
I think so. Well, I'll just elaborate anyway.
Okay. The first question is, Cyrus, what is your favorite childhood memory?
Yeah, I honestly, at the age of about 11, I spent a lot of time alone because I don't know, I can't remember why exactly. Maybe I was on the 8th floor, so going down would take too long.
Mm.
You know, so I used to know, I'm lazy by nature, lazy personified. Anything that I can do less, I do less. Even now I'm thinking, let's end the podcast. But I discovered as a young boy, one of the most beautiful things, and you know, somebody said, don't be so flippant, but nobody can understand how interesting and loving and happy your life is when you can scratch, as a male at least. I can't speak for all females, but some. And I just, on a Saturday morning, and now we're recording this on a Saturday, I just put my hand in and I just give it a good scratch. And
that's one of my favorite childhood memory.
Yes, yes.
Childhood memory?
Yeah, one of my best. And my dad asking us to, we put the AC, we had only one AC in the beginning. And he, okay, sorry, for income tax purposes, we have only one AC. And then and he, my dad, he's got this lovely middle class mentality where he would be like, you know, put on the AC at 9 in the morning, run it for 1 to 2 hours, and then it'll remain cold for the whole day.
Okay.
And then his trick was you lie on the floor if you don't believe it's, and the floor is always cold. So like an idiot, I would take my shirt off as an 8-year-old and lie on the floor at like 3 in the afternoon for that 1 hour of AC. But for some reason, then it seemed to work. Now, of course, I realize he conned us, but it was beautiful, beautiful memories.
That's...
Oh, yeah, and Tanya, the girl next door. But I was about 13, 14 then. Oh, my God. She left the windows open while having a bath.
Okay.
And I could see right into the shower area. And may I say that changed me as a man.
Something
until then,
me,
I only followed West Indies cricket. After that, I followed many other things.
Something tells me Tanya isn't real and you just made
it
up.
I just changed the name slightly. I'm just scared that our reach is a little more than I thought. I thought it was like 400 people, but it's about 1,000, and that's risky.
It's more like a million, Cyrus.
I hope so. Maybe one day. But and if there's a million, there's an odd Tanya will be featured at some point.
Yeah. All right. Want to go to the next question?
Well, no.
Yeah, go ahead, man.
Right answer?
Well, there was a yes or no question. Yes.
What's the weirdest place you've gotten stuck at?
Zipper?
No, oh, you mean as a person,
I am.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Sophia College, I was stuck in a... Sorry, yeah.
Yeah.
Because that's a terrible thing, right?
Let's
go back to that first. Yeah. as a male, again, not trying to be dirty in any way, but for a male to experience that kind of pain, when you're in a hurry and you put the zipper and your zipper is open and you just go for it fast and it hits the skin area and it gets caught. Oh, yeah. Those are terrible memories. I mean, came back to me like a oof. That wasn't fun. That was like, I don't know, Savaria the first time I saw it. The pain lingered.
Sophia.
Not that I saw it again, but you know...
I love
Ranbir Kapoor. So we're shooting this show called MTVU in 1996, one of the first things we shot. And so nobody knew us, and just like now. Nobody knew it was a waste of time. And it was difficult to get in, et cetera, et cetera. And I wanted to take a pee break. And keep in mind that I've been in Sophia all my life doing plays since 1985. But we were in another area, and they said, okay, somebody just pointed. And I went into this loo, which is only for women. And I went in and I realized there were only toilets. There was no urinal, but what the hell, you know?
It's Sophia's. It's a Sophia's, girls' college. Yeah, maybe that's how they are.
But then two girls came in and they screamed. Oh, man. And now in the Me Too generation, I'm just thinking, I would have been finished.
Yeah.
But you don't have an answer for that. It just looks creepy.
But you know, what do you do in these bathrooms nowadays, which are like somewhat kind of fancy? They don't just say men's and women's.
Yeah.
They have like these kinds of weird...
You think everyone who's been accused of molesting the opposite gender would want to use the transgender card? That sort of makes it okay. I'm like 50% there, so I didn't really do that. So I think that would be great. I like the transit. It's sort of toilet of transit. Anyone can pee in the same place.
Well, so co-ed toilets, right?
Co-ed toilets,
that's become...
Could you pee together? Is that allowed?
Sorry?
Can you urinate together, collectively, as a group, as a community?
So apparently in China, they have this, instead of urinals, they have commodes without any separation between them.
Wow. Yeah. That puts pressure
it's
on you.
It's just a line of commode.
That puts pressure. You're exposed.
Right next to
you're exposed
each other.
Completely. That's terrible.
So what? Basically, people are dumping right next to each other?
I guess.
Yeah. Also from the male perspective, if you're 6'9" and not in proportion, you know, that's going to be a joke for the local community.
Of course.
Because you don't want that. You've got to be careful of that. Boys, I've seen you two pee, and I got to tell you.
Right. So that was the weirdest place you got stuck in?
Why, top of the mind? No, there are many other places.
Top of the mind.
I'll go back in the car and remember 10 more better ones, and then what can we do? Record
we got
again?
A lot of questions, so we should go through them quick here.
What's your biggest pet peeve?
Oh, are you crazy? Proximity. I mean, there's so many things. Proximity I hate. As staring. Why do we stare? Why do Indians stare? Only we stare. You travel the world. Nobody stares at you.
People stare.
But here we stare. They don't stare in a way where they look away. Just the other day, I'm just driving the car. The guy's just looking at me. He's holding his looks. With my eyebrows, he said, what's the matter? He doesn't even respond. He thinks it's a show. It's a TV show. He's just watching it. You know, he doesn't care. He's saying, putting the volume louder in his head. You know, like, what's going on?
So I think
hate
that,
the staring.
No, but
man.
I think
I
the staring
it.
Is something that I think that we kind of overdo that. That's an Indian thing. I think that that's something that you see.
I don't ever feel
place.
The people really looking at me. Maybe we're just ugly. Outside the country, but you know, I don't really feel that in Thailand, you know, nobody really looks at you like that and that way. Proximity. Why do people always stand close? We have a real problem with standing close. We always stand close and we touch too much. We touch too much for no reason. Why do we touch?
Yeah, why is there so much physical contact?
I don't, that, do you realize we flick each other all the time? We hit the thigh, yeah. Put the finger in the chest. And I'm like, why?
The arm around the shoulder.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
it's,
you know, almost, I mean, like intimidation. Also, I feel like there we have too much of a hugging culture.
Too much of a hugging culture with everybody? I mean, yeah. That doesn't make sense. Yeah. With due respect to the Prime Minister, hug, they will be outside the country. You know, I mean, come on. Mutual funds are subject to market discounts. Okay. Oh, don't start me off with pet peeves. I've got so many. Okay, driving. Oh, I just, you know, I can't understand why pedestrians, when they're crossing the road, give me dirty looks. It's the road. Tell me, what option do I have? Let's divide the society properly. You tell me, should I drive in the sky? I mean, why do they stare at you? You know how much kundas I've got? I think I'm dead by now, karmically. Because they just keep staring at you like you're evil. But you're running across. In Marine Drive, they're running across staring at you. What does that mean?
One of my, I hate that shit.
Okay. These sound a little elitist. Now when I think about it, I want to retract it, but still.
No, don't. It's...
Yeah. That got you worked up.
Yeah.
All right, let's go to the next one. What's the one talent you have that we don't know about?
You know, I don't think that's the right answer to ask someone, because you just scrape the bottom to find any talent. I was thinking about it, that is, I actually don't have any talent. I mean, I can sing a little, I can dance a little, I can talk a little, but I don't really have one proper talent.
You're narrowing
really
the word
good...
talent too much then.
Huh?
You're narrowing the word talent.
If I go to India's Got Talent, what am I going to do?
Nothing.
Anyone can tell two jokes. It's not, no disrespect.
I was thinking about that. This. The thing with singing and dancing is that it's like, it's something...
Unless you're top of the line, what is the biggie? Huh? Even telling
Whereas
jokes.
Whereas with comedy, it's like you're just talking to people, so people don't... register it as quote-unquote talent.
One. And two, there's so many people talking to people now. How the hell do you stand out? You know, everybody's talking about people. And you can't even live from the internet anymore, because that whole generation's done. So where do you go? So what talent do I have? I'm very quick. I'm the fastest person. I can write fast. Mm. I can finish fast. Mm. Oh, women, please. Don't send in your thumbs up. Yes. God, they say all the wrong things. I'm quick. Quick speed is a good thing with me.
Quick is fast. Yeah, right? I think that's an ability.
The impatience that I've always had comes in handy a few times.
See, that's what I was saying. I think, you know, we use the word talent only to refer to singing and dancing.
Yeah, tangible,
kind of
tangible.
But there are a lot of different things that are like kind of like...
Like Rajnath Singh, who used to be Home Minister and now got dethroned. Yeah. What is his talent? He's like a poor man's Atul Bihari Vajpayee when you hear him speak. You know, he's got that little lil to him. But other than that, what? I just threw it out there for no reason.
No, no,
why would you badnam a guy you've never met or never will meet? Who does that? How low? This is my talent.
Yes.
Just to be small, snide, petty, childish, complex, irrational, illogical, painful, and feel that my problems are the only problems. I like that.
Cool.
I'll stay with that. That's my new talent. Right. Write it down.
The next one. What's the first thing you do in the morning?
Come on. Obviously, play with myself.
But as soon as you...
25
eye,
years,
you
golden jubilee,
eyes.
I'm calling spectators for this one. No, I'm one of those guys who get out of bed really fast.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I have a very bad sleep problem. One day I'll die, I'm sure.
Uh-huh.
I'm not a sloppy kind of thing. So I know I speak to a lot of people about this, and a few people I've observed sleeping, but I jump out of bed. So And also, I sleep only two hours, one hour. Mm. I don't sleep long hours.
Okay. What's the last thing you do
Why
before
are we discussing this? Are you going to kill me now?
No.
Understand the animal before you shoot. It's like that. Sleeps 2 hours. At 5:30, load the gun. Way to the creek.
But what's the last thing you do before going to bed? That's the next
question. I pee three times at least in a 6-7 hour period. So I keep peeing. So there's no last thing. I scratch a lot. Sometimes there are nocturnal emissions and my wife screams at me.
Mm-hmm.
But I think we've reached the point where she's just given up.
Okay.
That's about it. When I say emissions, you know what I mean, right?
Yeah,
I don't have to clarify.
Are you someone?
We're big boys, right?
Huh? Are you a good night kiss person?
To whom?
To
I say goodnight
kids,
to my kids.
Wife.
They also reply. My son says move, and my daughter says can you shut the door. So we have our own way, special way of saying bye to each other.
Right.
My wife says shut up and let me sleep, because she goes to bed at 8:30. I know we're like some, you know, Napoleon's army on the march or something. We're always in bed early and ready at 4:30. I can't meet anyone. You know, I wish I could have meetings. I'm up from 5 and there's no one to talk to. I was here at 9:30 for a 10:30 appointment. Not just being a loser. It's just, you know, the way it is.
Okay, question number 7. What's the accomplishment that you're most proud of?
I fought with this terrible CEO we have in the club who's anti-dogs, and they took me in front of the committee. Mm. And my father was, you know, he's not very sane at the moment and not in good health, but that was one of the few things. I thought he was really proud of me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and keep in mind, I've met, interviewed Bill Clinton and Richard Gere and Atal Bihari Vajpayee, Nelson Mandela. I mean, all these, you know, Amitabh Bachchan and God knows who. A lot of big names in my life, cricketers, etc. But none of that.
Mm.
But because I stood up to this terrible person, one day hopefully I will face on the fourth battle of Panipat in neutral territory, where there's no question of litigious behavior and that kind
what was
of crappy thing.
It was a keep the dogs out of the club situation?
Yeah, it's just a petty thing. You see what happens with, we are surrounded, I feel, in India with officialdom in certain places like building societies and clubs and things like that, where they don't understand that informality is the only way forward in a community. You cannot cannot behave like it's the army. That's why we have an army. That's right. Why you need that. You can't behave, you know, take the stick to everyone. It's just pointless. Because you're killing the whole leisure culture.
Right.
We're not relaxed anymore. We're worried. So you've got to find that balance between flexible and rigid. And,
so
and,
Mama Jim is a particularly annoying place.
Well, I'm just hoping that one day that cantankerous official is removed and then hopefully everything will be fine.
So I find...
But he's from another zamana, you know. Yeah. There's a lack of empathy. There's some cruelty.
Yeah.
And you know, they are what I call the pseudo-fascists who under powerful figures like the committee, they'll be very servile.
Right.
And then with certain people, they'll be very aggressive like staff and all that. That's the worst personality because you're not true to yourself.
Yeah,
you're just doing what you can to survive in a dirty way. You know?
I find some of this club culture stuff I find annoying, right? So, I mean, like Bombay Gym, for the longest time, you had to go outside to use your mobile phone. You couldn't even go onto the lawn, right? Willingdon...
No, the lobby was allowed as far as I can
know. For a couple of years, it wasn't allowed.
I didn't have a phone.
You had to go out. The Willingdon Club, I was there a couple of weeks ago with some friends, and one of the guys had gone swimming and was coming from there.
Yeah.
He was wearing like sandals, like Birkenstocks, not even like, you know, flip flops or something like that. Did not let him sit.
See, what we want to understand is that democratic traditions and elite clubs are at paradox.
Yeah.
To each other, if you look at it. It makes no sense, actually, because you're actually trying to live a very non-egalitarian sort of life. So you want to keep it, I think you have to in some way adapt.
Yeah.
It cannot be so aggressively, you know, like, are we on or not, or, you know, no way at all. And what they have to understand is that people can't just feel powerful by giving diktats out, because that it's just about ego. It's not. You think about what is the logical thing to do.
Right.
You know, if it's just a dog, it's just a dog, it's an innocuous issue. It should not go up to committees and all that. You know, it should be ended there.
Right.
Attitude problems, man. Yeah. Human beings have always failed us. Right from the start of time. I'm not a human being fan. Hence the whole issue.
Cool. Let's go on to the next one. What's the most beautiful place you've ever been to?
That's good. So many places. I would have loved to go to Jamaica, though, as a young boy. I thought it was West Indian. You used to practice the accent, man. But that didn't work out. Tough one. Thailand? I love Thailand. I like Sri Lanka and Thailand because they just give you a sense of good karma. That's a terrible thing to say with the kind of things that have happened between tsunamis and attacks and all that. But you just have a sense of niceness in the people. And for me, that's better than the look. When I feel happy with people around me, not touching me, not violating proximity, giving you that certain respect and whatever, I'm a happier person.
Okay.
So these two countries stand out for me always. I do like London because the one thing about London is the civility and the decency.
Mm.
You can basically most of the time just walk around and, you know, the rules are followed in a nice way, you know. Again, don't want to go to the side of the officious. Don't have too many rules, whatever happens. Yeah, but and the weather. The weather's always better there for people like me who sweat.
Okay.
So anywhere where the sweat stops.
All right. Cool. Who was your role model while growing up?
Oh, I suppose Temujin, also known to history as Genghis Khan. But I thought I'd get myself a little...
You haven't conquered nothing. Any parts
my mother
of
asked
Asia
me,
yet.
My mother asked me that day. I explained to my mom. I said, you please understand that everybody... All great conquerors were impatient because I was driving fast. She said, why are you driving fast? I said, all great conquerors was. And I started, you know, sprouting Zandros of Macedonia. I always like to use that real name to show how intelligent I am. But my mother has heard it 400 times. So Zandros, she knows it's Alexander, so I'm not impressing her. But I have that, you know, pontificating, pompous side. So I'm like, Zandros of Macedonia and Chinggis. Said, that's a real pronunciation. So she looks at me and says, but what have you conquered?
Burn,
Burn, my son was in the back, but he started laughing. And he said, the bathroom. He's the king of the bathroom because nobody goes there once he's gone. Nothing like mothers to cut you down to size, but I tell you that. Many times in my life, I've come back thinking no end to what, you know, I've shot something big or I thought a big ad campaign or whatever, come back with a chest out and all that, or somebody's recognized you. And what. And my mother will just say something stupid like, you left the geezer on. What kind of idiot are you? And it's like, you're back down. This is another idiot son who left the geezer on in middle class India, which drives the parents mad. For 4 hours, they've been waiting to point their finger at you for leaving the geezer. But I made Richard Gere. Who cares? You left the geezer on. Sorry, wake up.
What's your favorite place to eat out?
Oh, I love eating out. Yeah. But my only thing is I like other people to pay. Otherwise, it doesn't always taste less nice.
You don't go out that much, do you?
Lunch, all the time.
Yeah.
Kunal and I are eating out all the time.
Okay.
We have the usual suspects, all the Olympias, Delhi Darbar, you know, all the normal places that we go to.
Okay.
And then, but he has a wider palate, so they try different things.
Yeah.
Also, Mumbai has changed. You've got so many restaurants. Kalaguda, where we have a small office, there are five restaurants I didn't know were there. Because I go early morning and leave, and they're all night restaurants. So, a place called Americano or something. Getting huge.
I'll talk to you about that,
It's getting huge publicity, by friends and family saying, you have to go, you have to go.
I'll talk to you about that.
All right. It's a secret.
It's not a secret, dude. I mean, basically, I was planning a...
Americano propaganda.
We'll talk. We'll do this.
We have to do this offline. Because the FBI are on to us. Yeah.
All right. The next question is related. If you had to eat the same thing for the rest of your life, what would
it be? Okay. I will just go back to the old question. One thing I want to point out, the common touch has not gone. So as we made a little bit more money and got exposed, and Mumbai grew and became, you know, more, let's say, upper middle class in restaurants.
Right.
You got these fancy, your socials and all, for whatever you say. I know they're not, the budgets are good, but somewhat good, but still the palate is slightly more refined.
Right.
Okay. But I like what I've grown up with, and that has not changed at all.
Yeah.
I can still go to Martin's. I can still go to Olympia. I want, you know, my brain masala. Mm.
I like that taste.
Yeah, no, so that taste is not going to be affected. If you take me to the fancy or Oberoi's or Trident or whatever, and you know, a 4,000 rupee steak or whatever it is, I still like all the old stuff. So I'm good that way. Hence, I've not left my wife.
I agree. I like that stuff too, right? I mean, like, so Olympia is particularly good. I like Fooden a lot, man. I had
Fooden is very good, and Fooden Oshiwara is even better.
Is it really?
Yeah,
I've never been
stuck
there.
Yeah, Fooden is very good. Yeah. And the thing about tikkas is they get the right pieces.
Yeah, they do.
And so you think with the lower grade restaurants, they won't get the right pieces. Too much breast.
Yeah.
And I don't want to discuss breast on the podcast because that'll be, connotation is not nice.
Right.
Or not right, perhaps. It is nice.
Yeah, it is very nice.
Okay. Let's go to breast then. Topic number two. But their pieces are always very good. Just like five stars. You know,
juicy. I'm a big fan of a lot of these places, right? So,
and they don't hold back with the roti.
You want your...
I'm saying, look, if you're going to eat, just eat. You have to stop this crap. Mm. Put the ghee on the damn roti. Yeah. Put the butter on the damn roti. But just load the damn thing and eat it properly.
Eat when you're eating.
Eat when you're eating.
And when you're not eating, don't eat.
Absolutely. I think it's a much better way.
Choices.
My good friend Kunal is always fighting his own demons. Yeah. Should I put butter? I said, we're having a butter chicken.
Yeah.
You're having two bloody naans with it. And now you're worried about the little butter on your garlic naan. I mean, what do you... What? Where?
The way I treated this over the last couple of years. And I mean, like earlier, I used to do the same thing, right? I always try and be somewhat healthy. But last couple of years, it's like, you know, be on a good diet, generally speaking.
Be healthy or whatever you call healthy.
But when you're eating,
so you cheat once or twice or whatever and just eat.
Yeah.
What? Life is over, Abbas. Yeah. They've taken everything. This government has taken everything. We got food. Well, they've taken food also.
Yeah.
Oh,
if you had to eat one thing for the rest of your life, what would you eat?
At the moment, I'm a little sick of Parsi cuisine and all. I'm sick in the sense that I've overeaten it. So ask me right now. Mm. But the one thing that I would keep with me, and keep in mind that the government is vegetarian, is the potato. I believe the potato is like an honorary meat. It is my favorite thing in the whole world. And if there's nothing else left, I would eat the potato. Because I can eat the potato in any form.
Right.
Big potato, fried potato, obviously. Masala potato for Indian palate, obviously.
Mm.
A mashed potato. So, you know, the potato is a great friend. They have to elevate the potato. There will come a day, ladies and gentlemen, I have a dream. When my meats and my potato can live together. And their children can go to Stanford together and get degrees. And before you know, the potato is a free man. Yes.
It's a clever answer because most people named one dish. You named an ingredient. So that gives you
variety. No, but one dish is boring. Who can eat one dish every time?
Well, yeah.
You try that with marriage, that's bad enough. Now you're going to do that with food. No. You've got to give me a little genre here.
Okay.
A little flexibility. Stop being a bully. Are you a cantankerous man who's running a club? No.
Okay. What is a perfect day according to you?
Oh. I would the perfect day is when the energy output is less than, you know, required.
Okay.
I love doing nothing. I admire the lion a lot. The lion hunts twice, mates about 400 times, and does sweet F all in between. 20 to 22 hours sleeping and just lolling around, scratching. Oh, I love that. I can do that for a long time.
Okay.
Yeah. So, you know, as long as money's not an issue, there's, you know, for me, just hanging around, but in private dens. I'm a caveman.
Yeah.
I don't like to go anywhere. That's also to do with the heat. If we lived in Poland, I would go outdoor more.
Yeah.
I can't bear the heat.
Mm.
So what do I do?
Fucking hot.
Well, come on, honestly, if put you in a cold country, you would walk around a little bit more, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
You don't even realize it. If I put you guys in Europe and suddenly you're 4 hours you walked, you haven't noticed.
You know, you don't mind, right? I mean, like right now, if I we're in car, right? We're in the office right now.
I said Europe and you're in car.
My point.
You brought my podcast down.
If we were, let's say I was supposed to go for dinner somewhere in Bandra, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's not that far. It's a kilometer or a kilometer.
It's not
and
that.
A half.
If you were in London, you'd have done it for sure.
I would have walked. But over here, I'm not walking.
It's
that
a 15-minute walk, actually, you know, from Bandra to car. If you just go the right way, it's just 15, 20 minutes max.
I would not.
Normal walk in England, half an hour, 40 minutes. I'm telling you right now, you'll do 4 hours a day when I put you in Europe, you know, in a normal sense.
Okay.
So the point is, with Brexit, we have to now go to England and populate it. Give them they all want the sun. Let them have the sun for some time. Let us try their world. Wow, can you imagine? Josh Butler's in our team. We'll keep him back.
Okay.
Of course. What is a perfect date according to you?
Yeah, but dates are always good. Who gets dates wrong? You're a real idiot to get a date wrong.
Really?
Because everybody's on
I know a lot of people.
No,
Abbas, including myself.
No, I know, but everybody's on the top behavior.
Right.
Remember, this is the best you'll ever get.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're only meeting for 3-4 hours.
Mm.
You're already in a good mood. You put your aftershave, your perfume, you're dressed well. You know, your troubles are behind you.
Mm-hmm.
It's evening, you're eating, you're drinking, whatever the hell you're doing, there are friends around you. How do you get that wrong? It's terrible to get that wrong. Don't get that wrong, because it's only downhill from there.
What kind of dates do you go on with friends around you?
No, what I mean is you go to a bar or pub or whatever. Oh. I don't know now what the kids do, because, you know, I'm an old man. Yeah. But there'd be people around, so that also lifts the whole thing. No, everybody's in a happy mood. Have you noticed in like clubs, everybody's so happy to see you. The same guy who ignores you on Tuesday morning, he's like, hey, boss! Boss, of course, names are not important. Boss, what's up? Everybody's so happy. So that happy feeling is there. Yeah, can't screw up a date. I think second date, more pressure. Third date, more pressure. First date should be okay, because she said yes. Mm. It's an unknown quantity. Both of you won't get too much wrong in that. Mm. Unless, of course, you burp and, you know, do those kind of things, or make some right wing comment, or maybe sorry, left wing comment. I don't know which is right anymore. Is right, is left right, who knows? But I've had a few skirmishes with dates also. It's not like I have terrible dates, you know. Like, imagine what they're thinking. So my biggest problem is I didn't want to spend money. I always thought, like, you know, how much am I going to spend here? So I would start losing interest in the date and she'd order, you know. So they take out the menu and immediately you try and sidetrack them. Why didn't you go for the keema pav? I'd be like, no, I want to have the roast chicken. But the roast chicken is like 325, the keema pav is like 94. I'm like, but keema pav is much better value for money, and, you know, that kind of thing. So I would get a little derailed by those small things.
Okay.
Nothing has changed.
Okay, speaking of money, what's your most prized possession? Or not money.
No, money, I don't even know. Right now,
but just in general, your most prized possession.
I'm only interested in dogs, man. Honestly.
Okay.
I thought for a little while, I thought maybe I should get a bike and all. But then, you know, it's so hot. Mm-hmm. And I was also 18. I can't understand how you can ride a bike in Mumbai for a long time. I mean, Shravan, who's a sound engineer, does it all day. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I mean, it's just so hot. If it's short distance, maybe. But just think about it. No, but once the wind is blowing, Gary Lloyd told me, when the wind is in your hair. And all. I'm 47, I don't have any hair now. What wind is in your hair? Wind is more, hair is less. What am I going to do?
Okay, Cyrus, what was the last lie you told?
Oh, God, what do you ask? I'm a professional liar. I don't even remember. My biggest problem is, as I advance in age, I'm lying continuously, but I can't remember who I lied to and what. So I always try to get the reference back. So that something hits me. But I lie a lot, man. And when I was drinking, I used to lie a lot to my wife.
Okay.
Like, because she didn't like us drinking for whatever reason. I don't know where that came from, because I met her drinking. But, God, the lies. And one day she caught me and Kunal at the bar. She figured it out, because I'd gone from the morning to shoot for Bakra. And then I said, I've got this event and I'll come back late night. And I took pants. Long pants. Big mistake. Carried pants all day. So she put two together. And I remember Nasir, who was my guy at the gym in the car, calling me, saying, Madam Ai, and all that. And there's only 20 feet walk. And then Madam Ai, and what Nasir? And then my wife is standing there, and all the boys ran. There's nobody standing in the way of the cavalry. Oh, I had some bad moments. Yeah, lies. Lie all the time.
All right.
I don't have a problem with lying. Now let's talk about lying for a second. I think lying, this whole thing about honesty is bullshit. If you see a really ugly woman and she says to you, do you think I'm not attractive? Are you supposed to say you're not attractive? How is that good? That doesn't make any sense to me. You know, or if somebody does really badly in the exam, you'll be honest and say, listen, you didn't study, you're an idiot, you're a loser, you have no brain. No, even though that's probably true.
Right.
So why is it always honesty the right policy?
Honesty is not always the right policy, but honesty is mostly the right policy.
I don't think so. I think honesty is
I think white
man.
Lies for the sake of keeping the peace make a certain amount of sense. But
why should white always be the good color? Why can't it be black lies? Which
black
is small
lies for the keeping the peace make a certain amount of sense.
Thank you.
But
Cyrus is like Black Lives Matter.
Yes. Down with racism. Be dishonest.
What's the most courageous thing you've ever done?
Oh, that's going to be really tough. Can't we go back to lying? I have to come up with something.
So you can lie.
Oh boy. No, I don't know. This is tough.
I'm assuming all those...
We had a terrible accident once, and so we fell out of the... cut a long story short, Bombay Goa, and the bus went over, two people died, blah, blah, blah. And you're pulling people out and all that. And I had to take my shirt off and give it to someone to wear.
How long back
and
was
one
this?
Shoe had gone... 1991.
Oh, okay.
So I remember when we reached the hospital, I had just my pants on and one shoe. But then the problem is that 2-3 women were braver than me. So I had to come to the party. I didn't really want to help anyone, especially because one lady kept calling me Simon. She said, what is your name? So I said, Cyrus. Simon, help. And then suddenly one able-bodied man, because I was just scratched here and there, me and these three girls who were okay, four of us were doing all the, you know, Florence Nightingale helping people. Yeah, it's great for them. You feel like a hero for 5 minutes, and on the 10th minute you're like, can you get up yourself, uncle? So what have your legs gone?
All right. When you're having a bad day, what do you do to make yourself feel better?
I've given up on bad and good days anymore. I just try to escape everything. For me, it's just to finish everything and run. That's my philosophy.
Okay.
Yeah. Or not even run. Finish everything and just find your way after that. But yeah, people ask me all the time, are you always happy? Are you always jolly? I'm like, have you seen a man during an orgasm? He's not laughing. I mean, there's so many times while you're on the pot, you know, releasing. I mean, there are many times when you're not laughing, just use your head. And the worst things when people say, will you tell me a joke? When you're drinking and all that. Yeah. Hey, you're comic, or is it not? Is it a comedian? You're a comedian? Hey, jokes now. I'm like, what? Abbas, you get that?
Yeah,
if you
all
go to a
time.
Family gathering, someone who doesn't know you that well, so Abbas, acha, he's the comedian. Ha, bull. So now, what do you do then?
Then I quote the Joker from The Dark Knight, never do something you're good at for free. So then they're like, oh. Like, okay.
Is that Heath Ledger?
The Heath Ledger
Joker. Then he killed himself. Okay. Talk about depression. Oops. Ouch. Wait, why did we go there? Yeah.
All right. Let's take a last question before we go into break. What did you do with your first salary?
Oh, my dad always took my money. The first, I earned 100 bucks in 85 for a play called Brighton Beach Memoirs. The Padam Sees put it in a white envelope and all. 100 bucks at that time is a lot of money. Not bad. And I came home and dad said, well done and all that, and took it. Till about 2 years ago, he took all the money.
Okay.
But of course, he invested it and all that. But now my wife has sort of taken over.
Uh-huh.
And but ultimately, I don't have any control over the money. Mm. I just try to earn it and then they take it.
Okay.
Something like that. But it works better that way. Mm. You want to divide compartments. Otherwise, the world is terrible.
But did you buy anything for yourself?
No, I had a girlfriend. I won't take a name because she didn't really commit to me. But let's say her name started with Man and ended with Shah. And so Manisha said, and I quote her, that I know your problem. You've not understood consumerism. You don't have a consumer gene. Mm.
Right.
So really there are people like me who don't. It's not like I'm above material things or something. Mm. That's different.
Mm.
That's, evolved personality. I just don't have a consumerist quality about me because the way I was brought up, I just didn't have interest.
Mm.
We were pre-internet guys,
right,
remember?
Yeah.
So you didn't touch a button and say, seven t-shirts and you get one underwear free, even if it's a lady's underwear. What the hell? Just buy it. So we didn't have all that. So
right.
I actually don't have a strong consumer gene. Okay. I got to tell you, honestly, I get bored in malls. When we go on holidays, I hate going anywhere because Aisha and Kunal will actually stop. And they're not crazy about shopping either, but they will stop. And I can't stop for long.
Okay.
The shopping's not been a strong thing for me. We have to take a break while I figure out. I got nothing to tell you. I've got to tell you, my life is terrible.
It's been pretty interesting so far.
What?
Yeah.
And he couldn't shop? And he scratches?
Hey everybody, welcome to another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please make sure you do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank our sponsors for the month, Sawari, Storytel, and Paytm Money. Thank you for your support. Also, guys, we're still hiring, and as I've mentioned before, I think IVM Podcast is probably the best place to work in the world. So if you're interested in joining our team, we're looking for producers, content creators, audio engineers, developers, we're looking for business development people, we're looking for data scientists, we're looking for all kinds of roles. So if you're interested, send us an email to careers@indusvox.com and we shall get back to you hopefully and get you on board. We have a brand new show launching called The Origin of Things. It's hosted by one of the co-hosts of Simplified, Deepak Gopalkrishnan, better known as Chuck. On this show, he'll be focusing on the origin of famous brands. Chuck will drop fascinating hits throughout the episode, but the brand is revealed only at the very end. Will you be able to guess the brand before the reveal? Find out by tuning into the first episode launching on Wednesday, 19th of June. And Keeping It Queer is back with Season 3. The new season has more of everything, from stories to debates to discussions. The show also has two hosts now, Naveen Narona and Farhad Karkaria. Tune into the first episode of their reunion. On The Seen and the Unseen, economist Ajay Shah returns to talk to Amit Verma on episode 125. This time around, they do a deep discussion about the world of finance. On Advertising is Dead, Varun is joined by Shivram Parmeshwaran, senior marketing manager at LinkedIn, to talk about the brand and agency ecosystem in India. On What a Player, Siddharth, Akash and Mikhail are discussing the ongoing ICC Cricket World Cup 2019 and how most of the matches are washed out this season because of the rain. On States of Anarchy, urbanist Yang Sungi joins Hamsini Hariharan to talk about how the city of Seoul has evolved and what lessons it bears for cities in developing countries. Rocktails is celebrating 100 episodes of storytelling with Anand Sivakumaran. He's set to charm you again with his new kind of storytelling on this special episode. On The Habit Coach, Ashton talks about mind mapping and how it can dramatically boost creativity. He also discusses the most important tool you can have in your productivity arsenal. This week on Mr. and Mrs. Binge Watch, Anirudh and Janice talk about the women they love in the world of television. And with that, let's continue with your show.
All right, we're back after the break, and Abbas has got lots more questions to ask to learn more from the wise old soul, Yoda himself. Let's go.
Okay, what fictional character do you wish you could meet in real life?
Captain Blood, Rafael Sabatini, reference nobody will get.
Is it one of those pulp fiction novels?
Back in the day,
Edgar Rice.
William, Edgar Rice, Tarzan for sure. I read all the Tarzan books. Love Tarzan. Could speak the language. Chad Bulja, the lion. I miss them all. Kerchak. Where have you gone now, Numa?
Who's Captain Blood? Why,
Captain Blood, Rafael Sabatini book. 100 plus years old. Okay. What about this swashbuckling pirate? Immortalized by Errol Flynn. All from way back. Fantastic character. You know, it's kind of... dramatic entrances everywhere. You know, the heroic figure that you need. Right. You think you are. So it would be more like a Batman. Not a Batman. More like a Spider-Man.
Indiana Jones.
It's more like chest out leader type. Right. These are all dark heroes and irreverent heroes in Spider-Man's case. So difficult to give you an analogy. I gave up.
Okay.
That's right. But I'm trying to think of anything else. Oh, cowboys. I'm crazy about westerns.
Okay.
So, you know, I love Louis L'Amour. You know, I mean, all the old stuff. I can't remember now. The Sudden series. Have you read the Sudden series?
Which one?
Oliver Strange. No. Oh, you guys didn't grow up like I grew up.
Yeah, I just never got into westerns.
I loved Alexander Dumas. I loved the Musketeers. I liked Robert Louis Stevenson.
What was the Black Cowboy? I read that series.
The Black Cowboy.
No, basically there was a black guy who was a cowboy in the late 1800s, early 1900s.
Yeah.
I remember reading that series. But
I was born in 1971, so I think I missed that.
You're talking about 100-year-old books. It's not like I'm...
Two-Gun Kid, The Rawhide Kid, Lucky Luke, Asterix.
And your idol was Genghis Khan while growing up. So.
Genghis Khan is, given too much brutality and the rest of him is not looked at.
Okay.
You know, the building of bridges, the roads, you know, the way... I mean, look at them. They were a barbaric society. It's just unbelievable, that story. It's just unbelievable. One day, please read. Read a little bit about Genghis. It's fascinating.
Cool. The next question.
Never going to read it.
There are some interesting books about Genghis Khan. There's also, you should listen to the Dan Carlin podcast, The Mongols. Okay.
Really?
I
would like to listen.
I'll send it to you.
Okay, how long is it?
So there are 6 episodes, each are 4 hours long.
That's quite a bit.
It is, but you listen to it as much as you want to at any given point in time, no?
True. Is it in Mongolian?
It is. No, it's in English. Okay,
why are you even answering on this? We've been together so many years now.
I do not know the answer.
Most people don't talk to me.
That's true.
What was the funniest way you got injured?
Oh, I got hit in the eye at Silly Point once. Oh, that was ridiculous. If you're trying to chirp at batsmen, or, you know, if you're sledging people in any form of life and then you get beaten, it's like the worst thing.
What match was this?
So we're playing Harris Shield, is it? Xavier's?
Okay.
Versus Kirti College, which is Vinod Kambli's college. It's the only match we played because we lost, so we're out of the tournament. And lost badly. Mm. They won by 9 wickets. And, I mean, it's just no contest. So what to do? So standing at Silly Point, and Silly Point was better than Short Leg then because people are trying to bowl off stump. Mm. Short Leg, as people who know their cricket, you know, West Indies and all bowling short into the body, so Short Leg comes into play more. But on Indian pitches, Silly Point. And, you know, whatever, unless you have an off-break bowler, then Short Leg. Why are we discussing this?
You're discussing with yourself.
So, so Silly Point. So I would love fielding there so I could chirp. Because I was a chirper.
Right.
I realized that chirping was my strong point, not cricket. So I would say...
chirping, you mean egging a batsman on?
Yeah, egg. Not abusing, but just chatting with them, you know. Like, bhul gaya. Forward defense, forward defense. Aage, aage, aage. So I would do that. But no bench of
Bharat. Right.
But they would get irritated because in those days, Mumbai players didn't like to talk.
Okay.
It's changed now. Now everybody sledges.
Yeah.
But so it was fun. And then the bugger cut the ball. Idiot spinner bowled a ball which doesn't turn. I don't know why I use the word spinner. And he cut the ball and hit my eye. And I went out dunked like that. No blood came out, but it was swollen and black. And the two of them were off. The two batsmen mid-pitch conference laughing. Nobody asked about me, nothing. Of course, skipper said, you want to go back to Silly Point? Or you want? I said, no, I'll go to third man for 5 minutes. Go sledge somebody else. You know, like the Limbu Pani wala. I said, "Dolo kya? Hey, Limbu Pani ke? Limbu kaha se aage? Paris? Penchot?" Much better sledge for me.
Do you have any guilty pleasures?
Sweets, I suppose, like anybody else. I love girls. But my wife won't let me bring them home. She says no. She says no to sweets. She's okay with girls. So far, but on a limb on this. I don't know. Do I have any other pleasures? I'm a sloth.
Okay.
But I'm a caveman. If I have to describe myself, I think I'm last of the Mohicans when it comes to the male who's all male in that sense. I really am.
Okay.
Which, in the sense that I don't like to clean. I'd never wash my hands. I believe that's a terribly unmale quality. Emasculates you completely. I can't stand men who say, "Can I wash my hands?" You know, just before they eat lunch. Or there's this guy I know, a good pal of mine, who after driving has to wash his hands. Why? Because somebody else may have touched his steering. I'm like, what the hell? Come on, you can't wash your hands now. Let's just get to the restaurant and eat. But he has to wash his hands. Hand washers are amongst my list of people I can't stand. Oh. Could you sound more more Nazi than me? No. But I mean, isn't it true that none of us left? No one wants to be a bum anymore. Men are immaculate, correct, you know. Abbas has got a little bum-like quality, but, you know, still he's careful about how he looks. His beard is well done.
I think things have changed, right? I mean,
things have changed.
You want to... You want to be able to do certain things in certain ways. Yeah. But also I think that personally you become slightly different. I think I become different, right? I used to be exactly what you described, right? I do what I want to whenever I want to. Tidy, messy, this, that.
But I've got through women who've tried to change me.
Yeah.
I've got through them all.
Yeah.
And they've given up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now my wife uses, you know, like there's those long things. That sounds very... Sorry. I won't even bother explaining that. No comebacks. It's like the sledging in the hit.
What's your most favorite thing about your profession?
I don't have a profession. I just ask what they pay me for. Yeah. I wouldn't even know how to describe myself. Except just trying to earn a buck. So that's in some close to most people in India.
Yeah.
That's the ultimate profession. But I don't see myself as a comedian or an actor or singer or whatever the hell.
But
I think entertainer.
Entertainer.
Yeah.
Oh. And what's your most favorite thing about that?
That in the old days we worked less hours. Honestly,
okay.
I mean, MTV was wonderful because we did nothing. We played cricket for so many hours in a day. Never mind, you know, sometimes that would be the thing. We wouldn't even know who the guest is we're shooting. Yeah. We actually be like, overnight, okay, Deepak, you were 83, no? No, you were 83. Don't say 84. You know, we were playing games.
Yeah.
That's the truth about life. Life is what happens when you're busy making other plans. The thing is all in the background. Maybe that's the best way to treat life.
Yeah.
Just don't get involved with the serious stuff. The serious stuff is always actually not as serious as you think. What do you think?
I
mean, good philosophy.
Let's go with that. I think it never is.
Yeah.
What's the most useless thing you ever bought?
Well, I bought a pot seat for my dad, which he's not using now. That's $5,000 I can't take back until I'm of the right age. Would like to sell that on Amazon now. What do I get for that? But, oh God, with the kids, man. I mean, that boy, Mikhail, the fucker owes me a lot of money. Let me tell you about this fucking wrestling crap that we went through. So this wrestling was at its peak, okay? I mean, I'm sure it's still at its peak, but for my generation of parents, and the boys wanted their wrestler, and if one kid got it, then everybody wanted it. So he'd come home, oh, Raghav's got him, I gotta get him, what's going on? Who's this bloody wrestler? My mother, who couldn't tell, used to like a racist, she couldn't tell the wrestlers apart. She'd be given a name, she can't, you know, like, give a name of wrestler, John Cena, and she'll call him like Shiv Sena, you know? John Cena, Cena, you know? And she'd go armed with this poor information and come back with a guy with straw hair and I hate this wrestler. They were $800 a pop. At one point we had 40
the action figures,
40 man. Of these buggers, and within 1 year it was over. Within 1 year he was into cricket and Brett Lee, and I what do I do with these 40 guys?
I got keep 40. Them man.
What? I can't get any money.
No, keep them.
My mother, my aunt, Kunal, other people from outside. What do you want to go with? Get him a wrestler. Yeah, and even the better ones, he wanted two. You know, like Undertaker, he had 4 or 5 Undertakers.
Right.
Yeah, I remember my poor mother going and asking these names. You know, can I get an Undertaker? like, you know, it's so wrong. You know, it's an American name of some wild testosterone fueled nutcase. And I still have them. By the way, I have the rings. I have those because belts are all very important.
Yeah,
the belts were costlier than this. Boy, I got this belt. I got to get that belt. The welterweight belt, continental, intercontinental drift, something. I'm like, what are you talking about? It's an ugly, dirty belt. It doesn't go around anybody. That was very painful. I tell you, what they can do to kids, you know, and screw us because of that is unfair. So there should be a law against that. Why isn't our country taking this up? Forget global warming. First, do this. Get rid of the fucking wrestlers. Those figures are there forever. My poor mother's going to be playing with them because there's nobody else who's interested. Undertaker, John Cena.
Give them
Mommy
to me.
Cena.
Dude,
Cena.
I'll take them.
Wow.
Really? I usually collect superhero action figures, but I'll take some wrestling figures.
Superhero, I sort of understand, but these are... It's an act of theater where they just pretend to touch each other.
But they are also dressed in costumes and beating each other.
Anyway, you're peculiar. Peculiar man. That's your superhero status. Peculiar man.
The next question is, what's the best bad decision you've made?
I guess getting married. I hated the idea first, but now I'm really getting around to it. It wasn't the worst thing I ever did. You know, no, really, as you age, you'll be, you know, these are important things.
Yeah.
Trust me. Not to say that mother has to be replaced at some point because it may come down to that, but
Got it.
But I hate it because I had a lot of freedom. So Abbas is should understand this, and anybody listening to us, don't trade your freedom in easily. Just think about it. It's not that.
Okay.
You can't get it back. It's gone.
Even if
you get divorced, it's gone. Because once you're tainted, you're tainted. You're finished. You'll never be the same again. Your spirit is broken. You're like a horse who's already been ridden. Don't do it. What's Have you ever been called a horse? Is your potty
not
boy?
Really, no. What's the best pizza topping?
I love cheese.
Okay.
You know, I can eat cheese with anything. Do you like cheese, Amit?
I like cheese.
So cheese basically can go with anything. So I like... But the New York pizzas, the way that I remember them in 94 when I was there for some time, is that you take by the slice and the grease, you know, your hand is covered with it. Give you just that one tissue and whatever. Your hand smells of grease for a long time and you can actually just have a cheese topping and it's a killer pizza.
No, but so cheese is part of the pizza itself, right? Does that count as a topping?
The extra top, extra cheese. I'm saying just cheese. Right. So the cheese is just unbelievable. Yeah. And it's sort of, you know, it sticks to your mouth and, you know,
it pulls like
a noodle.
It does.
Terrible use of language. But I love that. That smell of the New York pizza. Wow, talk about sense memories.
Cool.
Yeah, you got me thinking.
Wow.
Yeah.
Let's stop the show.
What trend makes you feel old?
Well, all these, the language that they use firstly and how quickly, you know, so we had a meeting before some show and these guys were telling us that we have to talk to a millennial audience. The other guy said, well, the millennial is already gone. It's been replaced by some new audience.
Yeah.
And then they had an internal fight and I'm thinking, what? Millennial's gone? I'm below millennial. Like, I haven't even understood them and they've already gone to the next, which means in the fuse there'll be somebody else.
Yeah.
And I'm still on millennial. You know, I'm still trying to understand the millennial animal. Oh, God.
We are past Gen Y and we're now into Gen Z.
And the other strange thing is when us 40 plus guys use the language because it doesn't go off our tongue so well.
Right.
And when you hear some uncle in a party going, lol, huh? Just for no reason. Two guys are talking. Vijay and Ajay. Vijay says, haan, toh do aadmi the, baar mein gaye, phir ye hua, wo hua, haan, haan. Lol. I'm like, it just sounds incorrect.
Right.
It is incorrect.
Implausible, absolutely.
But it is incorrect.
But it doesn't when my kids say it or their friends say it. They just say it. They carry it off. No, they say things.
They don't
you know,
say lol. They'll say
they
LOL.
Don't say lol. They don't say lol. They don't say lol. But my daughter has said lol dad, but it's sarcastic.
Yeah.
And then it works, you know.
Yeah.
So I don't know, but we should just stick to where we come from. It's butchered up. Butchered up, do you remember? I'll butcher you, man. Abbas said before your time.
Yeah.
Those are phrases from South Mumbai that I grew up with. Butchered up was huge. I'll butcher you.
Booched.
Yeah, you'll get booched, man. Bugger. Bugger was
like
big.
Sorted is a very South Bombay thing, like sorted.
Not in 1980s.
No, I don't think so. I think sorted is something that I never heard over there. I heard after I started coming to here.
I hear South Bombay kids, dude. That dude has survived for the last 10 years. That has survived.
Dude and bro.
But their real names are Brijesh and Rajesh.
So I feel like bro is more South Bombay. Yeah. Dude is kind of more...
No, we moved to Brav now because we are British.
Brav,
So Brav. You're Brav.
Okay. What's a terrible movie that you love?
But I like all the cowboy films, which are all rubbish.
But they weren't terrible.
No, Good, the Bad, and the Ugly is rubbish.
No, it's not. But, I mean, it's a classic,
It's a classic, but, you know, come on. It's not like rocket science film.
It's not, but I mean, like, it's still. I mean, like, it's about pacing and it's about, like...
Even Magnificent Seven. I love Magnificent Seven. I can quote from the film, but, you know, I mean, it's good versus evil.
But, again, I wouldn't call these bad movies, right?
There's some great moments. Because you remember the fundamental of Magnificent Seven is why does Yul Brynner's character come to fight? Because he's, as a gunslinger, he's been offered lots of money in his life, but never everything. They come with just those three bundles, the Mexican peons. Just three bundles of jewelry. That's the whole village's collections. That's one small emotional moment. You should have got that from the film. Now, of course, you've seen the new version with Denzel, so you may not get that anyway.
There's a Denzel version of Magnificent.
Yeah.
What are you saying?
Seth MacFarlane and
it's Magnificent 14.
Then, but it didn't do well at the box.
No, but still, Denzel in action movies is always good.
Yeah,
I enjoy.
I'm a big Denzel fan.
Yeah,
top five actors. We forgot Denzel. Denzel's huge.
That was in the future or in the past.
But if we ever have this conversation, if we did or will do,
because
I haven't taken my pills. I haven't taken my pills, so I don't know.
I would actually put Denzel like almost at the top.
I can't think of. There are two, three absolute iconic performances.
Glory, Training Day.
Training Day comes out of nowhere. And look at Training Day. Training Day from start to finish, you can't fault him.
Even the new action is The Equalizer.
I like Equalizer also.
Amazing.
This is one where he shoots everybody.
Malcolm X.
My God, I've forgotten all these. One where he's the coach. The one where he's the lawyer.
Remember the Giants?
To Tom Hanks.
The Pelican.
Philadelphia.
Fantastic.
Oof.
He's an insanely good actor.
The
basketball movie.
What is it called?
Directed by Spike Lee.
I can't remember any names. I'll just call it the basketball movie.
I guess that's good enough for now.
Okay. The next question, answer, I guess we all know, but what game are you really good at?
Chess.
Really?
Yeah, but now my son beats me. That day he said, I beat you in 6 moves, he beat me in 5.
Okay.
What?
Yeah, he's got damn good, man. Maybe the mind is just sharper at 16.
I guess.
Or maybe because I've tanked so many matches to stop him crying. But now, you know, just natural reflex. I can't tell anymore.
Five moves is like destroying. You
know,
that's not...
It's like while playing cricket with your kid or whatever, you know, and the boy, and you're tanking it a little bit and letting him, you know, improve. And then one day the ball hits you in the chin. You know, like, when did the guy bowl like that? Just something happens. But I love chess. It's one of my favorite games because air-conditioned comfort. You don't sweat. You can keep your shirt off throughout. And mostly I used to win. Those days may have gone behind me. Cricket is my favorite game.
Of course, yeah.
But I like all. I follow boxing still. I always did. I love the sport. And tennis. I follow tennis. You follow tennis? I don't follow American sports that much. But I have my good friend Amit Doshi on my left.
Yes, I do.
So now I have a working knowledge that
Toronto Raptors
Golden State Warriors.
State Warriors in the first game of the
and that curry, you know, and curry in America is not a dish. It's the richest fucking sportsman.
Okay, as a child, what did you wish to become when you grew up?
A king.
Okay, next question. What extracurricular activities were you involved during school?
Singing, elocution, the usual rubbish that people don't have any talent to. You know, the same collection of prizes for no reason. Bring them home. Mother is very proud of you. Nobody else cares. Especially if she brings it up in a cocktail party. My son, elocution first place. Right. Oh, okay. Borderline, you know what. Same gender lover.
I think you like the next question. Yeah. If you could have dinner with anyone from history, who would it be?
I think my favorite military leader would still be Alexander. I think there's been no one like him.
Okay.
Whatever people say, the hype and this and that. And end of the day, he's, you know, it's like the Wasim Akram philosophy that David Lloyd spoke of. Lancashire. I'll quickly explain the references. So when he played for Lancashire, finally Wasim becomes captain. Mm. Clive Lloyd before him was the captain as well. Right. So the international becomes the captain in these places because of the status of the international of Wasim Akram and all that. So Wasim, the tradition is, and I think I've told you, that you have to give the speech as the captain because England was huge. This is back in the day. And so David Lloyd says, now Wasim is captain, skipper, address your team. Mm. So he looks around at the team and goes, okay, follow me. He just walked out. They all followed him. That was his speech. So Alexander had that quality. You know, he would go first, always. Yeah. Alexander in all the battles went first. Right flank, up front. He never went second. He always went first. Not all the leaders did that. They did that initially, and then they were told to go back and be hidden and protected. This nutcase, till the end of his life, went first. In Multan, he climbed the wall because nobody wanted to. They had enough of this Indian area.
Right.
And they wanted to go back. The heat was getting to them. They were missing home. They refused to follow him. Mm. So he climbed the wall and entered the fort alone. Mm. He held back people in Multan fighting with his sword. But because of his legend, they were scared to approach him. Mm. So he was injured in 17 places.
Okay.
And finally, they out of, you know, the Greeks, the Macedonians came in. But the fact of the matter is, I don't know if he was actually mad. It's unbelievably reckless.
Yeah, no, that
but
is
what a leader in terms of what the men would do for him, because unbelievable. The kind of leader who will always go first. Mm. And that's something special terms of leadership quality.
Yes,
I go... I never asked you to go. It's like that.
When you mentioned Multan for a second, I was like, are you talking about Wasim or
Wasim
Alexander?
Is Lahore. Multan is Sindh. Actually, don't get along. Punjabi speaking, Sindh speaking.
That's true.
Sindhi speaking. Why do I give him lectures? He's like another Mikhail. He's going to treat me like Mikhail.
Read about Jenkins.
You go and try to show your superiority to the younger person in terms of knowledge, and then one day it's like, move.
Okay. If you had the world's attention for 30 seconds, what would you say?
I would say, forget all this peace stuff. Let's all go to war. Let's get it over with.
Wow, okay.
Let's end it now. I've had enough of this crap. The break is over. Let's meet you.
Yeah. What's an app that you hate?
No, I've got another solution for all this, and that is, why can't the leaders fight? Okay, let's be intelligent, okay? If two countries don't get along and can't take it anymore, why can't the leaders fight? Let's just have a fight.
There is a history of some of that, right? I mean, like where you have a champion which is kind of created and...
But I say the leader, not a champion, not the best fighter.
Hercules and...
Correct.
Not Hercules.
Achilles. Yeah,
Achilles,
so instead of sending your Achilles out, I'm saying why can't the leader, whoever he may be, Donald Trump doesn't get along with Jinping and Donald Trump in the ring. Wrestle till, you know, we can have action figures. Yeah. I buy one for Amit, one for Mikhail, one for Abbas. Let's go.
No, but even if you get to the point of just having a champion fight, right?
I mean, why like, kill everybody?
More logical,
why have nuclear warfare? Yeah. Why go through all this waste of time? We can have great Netflix will make a killing out of it. I'm not against Amazon. If they have better figures, come and talk to us. We're always available.
Yeah.
So come on, it'll be fun.
Yeah.
And imagine people will finally know the leaders of smaller countries.
Yeah.
Mm. What? Bielorussia? Oh, great. Because now they know, because he's going to be fighting
that Philippines
North Korea.
Dude would like kind of rip people apart.
Oh, he's a duffy.
Putin would become the most powerful person in the world.
Or is it all hype? You know, because he's all chest and all that. But then
also have R56 in chest.
Come on. What about Imran Khan? I mean, he's one of the fastest bowlers the world has ever seen. You want to get in a ring with him?
Real athlete.
Be a little careful. Oops. This is going to be a fun thing. Write into us, please.
Actually, we should do a...
I think it's a great idea.
Yeah, you know what? Well, one of the next times we do these kinds of weird cock and bulls,
yeah.
what we should do is we should do a kind of 64-leader bracket. Who would beat who in a fight?
Yeah.
That'll be so fun. It's a World Cup.
Yeah,
you have 64 teams playing, in a sense.
You have 64... We'll identify 64 world leaders and we'll kind of like think...
And you're seeding Putin one, huh? I'm a little worried about that. Kim Jong-un would be one for me. Kim Jong-un has never lost. Well, mostly because they kill the guy for...
What about countries that have female leaders? Do they also...
You want parity? You want parity? I give you parity.
The Prime Minister of New Zealand would probably kick like 90% of people's ass.
Besides, if you were in a ring, you'd rather be with her than Kim Jong-un. Hey, it's a win-win.
Okay, Cyrus, what's an app on your phone that you hate but use anyway?
Oops. Refer to next question, please. app. If I have to, the erotica. But I actually scar the thing for, Shravan will understand, or supplements all the time. I'm always looking at what can this do, what can that do. And I always like, I look at weird things like, I'm talking about videos, not apps.
Talking about apps.
Anyway, I don't really use apps. I can't think. Is there any app I use?
I don't know.
Hair grow back app or something, maybe. I don't know.
You lose your Instagram password every time you need it.
Now the complaints are starting. My latest thing is watching Bruce Lee fights, which I don't know if they're real or not, because they keep saying we've shot this footage.
A lot of it is photoshopped.
It's photoshopped, right? They just put it together and I'm like, okay,
there's a very famous video of him playing table tennis, which is definitely photoshopped.
No, videos where he's scrapping on the set with people have challenged him and all the show. 18 seconds of fierce fighting. Can't tell probably what's happening. Mm. Can't even tell if he's an actor. I can't tell.
Don't know, man.
But then, the legend lives on.
What's the stupidest thing you've done because someone dared you to?
Oh, I drank milk from the floor in Xavier's to impress... the girls didn't ask me to. The boys asked me to. And I thought I'd impress this girl who I'd anyway joined the Russian class just to be next to her. And then I got 1 on 50.
How do you drink milk from the floor?
So, someone had dropped milk. Someone had dropped milk from their this thing. They were mixing a chai and they dropped the milk on the floor. Like, and I said, I told them, look, you challenge me to lick it, I'll lick it off the floor. So the boys said, okay, come on, lick it off the floor. Then I made sure the girls are watching. And then when I licked it, the reaction I got from the girls was so bad, I can't tell you. It was like, I thought they'd think I'm a hero, but you've got to think this through. And they looked at me like I'm an idiot, like a village idiot, like a fool's fool. Like not even a fool, but the 64 teams, I'm the last guy.
Okay, what's the wildest thing you've done in a hotel room?
No, we broke 60-odd glasses, MTV, I think it was maybe Aguada, one of the Tajes in 1997.
60 glasses.
So they took us for what they call their appraisal weekend and all that. We had 2 days of workshops and then a real drink up. And so after the workshop, I was pretty neutral because there was just 3-4 VJs and they didn't have anything to say. Nikhil Chinappa owed some 40,000 to the company for laundry. That was the only complaint. Imagine no complaint about me.
Right.
Because I'm so middle class that even when I went to hotels, I would always order the cheapest thing because I didn't want the company to suffer. Yeah. It's just natural for me to do all that. Yeah. I always look at the right side. I'm a right side menu guy.
Right.
But there are a lot of people who aren't. And they may even come from poorer backgrounds, but they don't have that thinking. Yeah. But we just can't stop ourselves. Mm. I go abroad. I always look at the right side. Mm. Everybody says, take a look at this. It's a lovely dish. And I'm like, right side. I don't read the left side. I read right side. Then I read it. Is this wrong? Is this wrong, Amit?
I think I follow the same.
Anyway, it's the way we were brought up. I can't change that instinct in me. So finally, they release us and and the bosses want to drink. Sunil Lulla, the best boss of all. And so he was wearing his yellow socks and getting drunk, having shots. The night just went on. And once the bosses get drunk, who gives a fly and all these pretty girls and it's Goa. And then me and this guy called Gajendra, who also played hockey for Maharashtra State, he and I had decided to have this competition where we drink a sip and we throw the glass. And people started joining us. And then suddenly the people coming in, catering guys saying, what the hell's going on? And all that. I was really almost so drunk I couldn't tell. But the next morning there were some 72 glasses bill and then five of us are called up inquiry by the committee of inquiry. Lulla and gang all as drunk as us. Broacha, what happened? I don't know. I can't remember. Why do you break glasses? 72 glasses, how do you break? I don't know. I can't remember. It's a stupid game.
Okay, what are you freakishly bad at?
Almost everything. I think it would be easier to make a list of what I'm good at. Yeah.
Okay, what is your favorite type of workout?
Well, there's no favorite type, but I've become a racist in the gym in the sense that if you're not intense enough, I just get irritated.
Mm-hmm.
So that I do have. Low intensity people irritate me. And in the way I go to, oh my God. It's almost not. So what happens is all of them move to 7:30. Mm. The 3-4 of us come in at 6:20. Mm. And they all come after we're done.
Mm.
It's because, we can moan and groan and shout and scream. Our workouts are, so I have this guy, Abhimanyu, who's saying, bang shot, push it, come on. Okay, and that's the way we are working out. And then they come in and so this lady called Amrita will go, "Hi guys, I've eaten too much this weekend. I need to do 2 extra push-ups." And just, the whole energy has changed, you know. And then she comes and says, "Broacha, can you move your weights in the way?" I'm like, "What? It's a weight room. Yeah. What does that even mean?" I don't understand. You've got these heavier dumbbells which we keep, because if you slide them underneath the dumbbell rack, mm-hmm. I take 5 minutes to pull them out, the 50s and the 45 kilos. It takes 5 minutes and I have to load them, pick them up. You know, they don't understand how much time goes in all that. So we keep it there so we can access it.
Right.
So there's like weight training people and they're like, "Chuts." Now, I don't, like, if I was blind, I wouldn't go to a library and say, "I want to read a book, but I can't. So, you know, what should I do?" You know, it's like that. So that, in that sense, I've become very intolerant. I can't stand all these people. I'm like, if you don't want to work out, why are you here? If you don't want to drink, why do you go to a bar? If you don't want to eat, why do you go to a restaurant? You don't want to masturbate, why are you in the bathroom? Well, come on.
Okay, last 3 questions. What do you get every time you go grocery shopping?
I like shopping for food, especially when I go out of town.
What's the
I
one
go straight
thing?
To the supermarket. No, I like my whole list of things.
Okay. Like, what's the one thing every time?
I need to drink something sweet. And I try to find something which is not too fattening. So a dietary, as Mr. Amit Doshi has discovered, some middle path for our minds. But I have this thing. So I need like, I definitely need that. So I'll go and find something. I like to try different colors. I love colors. So if I see a purple color, so cranberry
Gatorade,
color.
Basically. Yeah. You want Gatorade?
Well, Gatorade, I always keep Gatorade handy, but I always try to get the fat, the sugarless one. Yeah. So there's sugarless sweet drinks also if you look really hard. And those things, do I sound very gay?
Not really, not at all.
No, apologies, gay is good. We're going to have a gay spokesperson next week, or sooner or later.
Sometime
soon.
In the future.
Or
yeah,
it'll happen.
Or maybe it's already happened.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Time is a fungible thing.
We just can't control time, can we, Indians?
Which kids' movies scarred you for life?
I saw that Hannah Montana film. last few months of my drinking, my daughter wanted to see a movie called Thunder.
Okay.
Which is the story is thus. The woman's mother becomes a bear.
Okay. That's brave.
Brave. Yeah. Not Thunder. Now I'll explain why I thought it was that. Why did you watch that movie, Abbas?
Because it was a Pixar movie. It won an Oscar.
That's the reason.
What Pixar is like,
I came home at 4 in the morning.
I agree, it's Pixar's and Aisha weakest
said,
film.
Aisha said, "We are going for a 9 o'clock movie with your daughter. I don't care what condition you're in because this is what you promised."
Yeah.
So 9 o'clock in the morning with popcorn shaking in my hand, I'm sitting there and it's the world's worst film.
It's
a woman
not.
Becomes a bear and for the rest of the film she's trying to become a woman. Yeah. I'm like, why am I watching this? This is like I'm drunk.
What
this is
all
the kind of things you look at when you're drunk. Oh, that woman looks like a bear. Oh, that bear looks like a woman.
It's heartwarming and it's about the mother and daughter bonding.
My daughter has emasculated me beyond compare and she actually likes Hulk and everything else as well.
Right.
But I have to compromise. Now I'm singing Ariana Grande songs in the car with her and all. Grande, sorry. I don't know what... You know, daughters can really change you, whether you like it or not. It's very, very scary. But
it's a very
brave,
unique,
right?
Brave,
scary.
Yes.
Film that comes to mind. Yeah.
Okay, last question.
Yeah.
If you were arrested with no explanation, what would your friends and family assume
that I'm
you
not,
had done?
Now that I'm not drinking, there's only one vice left. Wink, wink.
You've already been caught once, so...
I think I make no impression on the women, so they don't complain. That's also, I'm like that fly with, you just can't, you know, actually land.
Right.
So I'm okay, yeah. But I hope not. Anyway, guys, it's been very entertaining. I now need to see my therapist because I've gone through all kinds of things and realized that I'm quite a chute. That's the moral of the story. Quite a chute.
Any questions you'd want to ask us?
Why would you do this?
To know you better.
Have you cleansed your soul now? Are you feeling better?
Yes, I am.
Do you feel you're in the presence of a human?
Yes.
Oh my God. Oopsie. Let's all hold hands and cry.
Okay.
All right. Okay, folks, great news for me, not so much for you. We're going thrice a week. We're not repeating shows. We're going on thrice a week, 2 regular shows and a new one, the birth of a new one called Lanso, Left Arm Not So Orthodox. It's talking cricket. 2 great minds talking cricket. One who has never played the game and the other, well, relatively less inexperienced. The one and only, what's my name? Cyrus Broacha. Lanso. New episodes every Wednesday. Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter, on Cyrus Says In. Or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
And that's what Cyrus says.
Manasana gol gappya sarkhi astat. Hi, hello kartana vegri, ani boltana vegri. Ani gappa martana vegri. Mitra zhali ki vegri, ani shatru manun vegri. थोडक्यात दिसणारी वेगळी आणि असणारी वेगळी, कधी आंबट कधी गोड कधी तिखट तर कधी चमचमीत, आणि कधी कधी हॉट अँड स्पायसी सुद्धा. आणि म्हणूनच गप्पा, सॉरी गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर फक्त तुमच्यासाठी दर बुधवारी IVM पॉडकास्टच्या ऍपवर, वेबसाईटवर किंवा युट्यूब चॅनलवर सुद्धा ऐकू शकता. तुम्ही आमचा पॉडकास्ट वेगवेगळ्या पॉडकास्ट प्लॅटफॉर्म वरती ऐकू शकता. फक्त सर्च करा गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर आणि आमचा पॉडकास्ट ऐकत रहा.
Hi, I'm Vishal Gondal, an entrepreneur. I've had the chance to meet and understand how some of the super achievers have hacked their way to success and they have done spectacular innovations. Now, I take a closer look at these people's lives to find out what lies beneath the force, only on the Vishal Gondal Show. Episodes out fortnightly on Wednesdays on the IVM website, app, or your favorite podcasting platform.